Praise the Lord. God is good. We all should listen to God's voice. Psalms 46 verse 10 says, "Be still and know that I am God." It is in stillness, not busyness, that we tune our spiritual ears to hear the voice of God. The Lord always speaks to us in that still small voice. But often it's drawn out amid all the turmoil of our daily lives. This is very important. Most often we mistake the voice of the Lord for our own thoughts. That's right. I said the voice of the Lord comes to us in our own thoughts. John chapter 4 verse 24 says, "God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth." This is saying that communication with God is spirit to spirit, not brain to brain or mouth to ear. The way we communicate in the physical realm, the Lord speaks to our spirits, not in words, but in thoughts and impressions. Then our spirits speak to us in words like, "I think the Lord wants me to do this or that." The Lord doesn't typically say you do this or that, but he will impress your spirit to do something, and then your spirit says, "I think I should do." Therefore, we often miss the leading of the Lord, thinking it's our own thoughts. Dear friends, brother and sisters, Psalms chapter 37 verse 4 says, "Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart." This verse has often been interpreted to mean that the Lord will give you whatever you want, and has been used to justify selfishness, greed, and even adultery. But it doesn't mean that the Lord will give you whatever you want. It means that when you are seeking the Lord, he will put his wants, desires into your heart. He will make his desires become your desires. The Lord changes your want to. Dear friends, James chapter 1, 19 tells us we should be quick to listen, slow to speak. That is never more true than when we are listening to God. There are lots God wants to share with us. If we will just listen, the Bible gives us a lot of benefit to listening to God as well. Listening to God proves you are his child. John chapter 8 verse 47 says, "Anyone whose father is God listens gladly to the words of God. Since you don't, it proves you aren't God's children." Listening to God makes you wise. Matthew chapter 7 verse 24 says, Anyone who listens to my teaching and obeys me is wise, like a person who builds a house on solid rocks." Listening to God gives you a solid foundation to build the rest of your life upon. In Hebrews it tells us that listening to God keeps your heart soft. Three times God tells us in the letter to the Hebrews that you should listen and not harden your heart. Hebrews, book of Hebrews, chapter 3, verse 7 to 8. Today you must listen to His voice. Don't harden your hearts against Him. Hebrew chapter 3, verse 15. But never forget the warning. Today you must listen to His voice. Don't harden your hearts against Him. Hebrews chapter 4, verse 7. Today you must listen to His voice. Don't harden your hearts against Him. Dear friend, you should listen to God's voice. Listening to God protects us from those who wish to do us harm. John chapter 10 verse 8 tells us, all others who came before me were thieves and robbers, but the true sheep did not listen to them. Listening to God keeps us from stumbling. 1 Peter chapter 2 and verse 8 says, they stumble because they do not listen to God's word or obey it. We live our lives on shaky ground when we do not listen to God. We are unwise in our decisions when we do not listen to God. We get hard-hearted when we do not listen to God. If you do not listen to God, your heart becomes very hard. We stumble when we do not listen to God. And we drift away from God's purpose and plans for our lives. Our lives when we do not listen to God. Dear friends, are you listening to God? Today is time to listen to God. Whatever you do, wherever you go, listen. Listen to God. He's speaking with you in His small voice. Try to listen to God's voice. He wants to guide you right away. He wants to instruct you right away. Are you willing to listen to God's voice today? Come near by God and listen His small voice. God wants to speak with you. God wants to communicate with you. God wants to change and bless and touch your life. Submit yourself to God and commit your life, dedicate your life to God and listen to His voice. Once again, Psalms 46 verse 10 says, be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. May God bless you.